we can access the model preferences from the toolbar menu. For models based on data sources or local files, we can access these preferences only after data preparation is complete and the model has been saved. In the general settings, we can see the model type, planning or analytic, and enter a description if we want. There's a shortcut to the planning and time range settings where we can enable or disable planning features if appropriate. On the Access and Privacy tab, we can set our data security preferences. At the top, we can see our own privileges for the model. Data auditing lets administrators monitor data changes in planning models when users change values in any public version. Refer to the video on monitoring user activity to learn more. Data locking lets us prevent unauthorized users from changing values during planning operations. When we enable data locking, we can set the default lock state for cells in the model, open or locked. This feature works in combination with the data locking owner settings configured in the individual dimensions. Refer to the video on data locking to learn more. The restricted export option prevents users from exporting the model to a CSV file. The model data privacy option prevents anyone other than the model owner from viewing the model data in stories unless explicitly granted access by an administrator. Models with privacy enabled also allow administrators to configure detailed role-based security settings that are not available for other models. Refer to the videos on model security and model privacy for more details. We can also enable data access control for each of the model's dimensions. When data access control is enabled, read and write columns are added to the dimension, where we can assign the appropriate permissions for each member. On the Fiscal Time tab, the Fiscal Year option lets us set up a financial year that doesn't match the calendar year. We can set the starting month, name the fiscal year based on the calendar year in which it ends or begins, and label fiscal periods with month or period names. On the Planning and Time Range tab, we can enable planning capabilities for the model if we want. Note that some preference settings are not available for all data sources, and some settings can't be changed after the model has been saved. Planning models allow authorized users to write data changes back to the model from stories. We can specify the date dimension to use for planning purposes, the earliest date we want the model to include, and how far into the future we want to plan. On the Currency tab, the Currency Conversion option lets us import data in different currencies and convert them in stories. When currency conversion is enabled, currencies must be defined in one of the model dimensions. We also need to select the table that contains the exchange rates to use. Refer to the video on model currency settings to learn more. When we use currency conversion, we can import pre-converted actuals if we want. This allows us to import actuals data in various currencies along with those values already converted to the model's default currency, rather than using rates in the currency table to perform the conversion. Refer to the video on pre-converted actuals to learn more. We can also set the maximum number of currency conversions we want to be able to display simultaneously in stories. Finally, on the Data and Performance tab, we can set the model to optimize the story building performance, which prevents automatic data queries when users interact with charts or tables. With this option enabled, users can choose when to refresh the query. In addition to the model preferences, each dimension has its own settings. Refer to the video on adding dimensions to models to learn more. Thanks for watching.